So the biggest mistake, write this down. I'm serious, especially if you want to be successful. The biggest mistake that somebody in your space, the syndication space, has ever made is that they add value to other syndicators and they completely miss the boat for their passive investor that they wanted to add value. So they go and they have guests on where the guest teaches, how do I find a deal? The guest teaches, how do I do the deal? And not only that, and I don't believe in being scarcity mindset. I don't believe in that. It's going to sound that way. Not only that, you also are adding the competition too when you are having other syndicators on your podcast teaching how to syndicate. Now, if you even have a passive investor listening, now they have more options. Now they have more people to trust. And they're also not getting the value that they're looking for. Remember the three things that we wanted? And this can maybe start your value. Teach them how to find a good market. Teach them how to ask good questions and vet the operator. Teach them how to vet a deal. If that's the content and it's for your passive investor, like let's just pretend and assume that you want to attract passive investors, you have to add value to a passive investor. And so when it comes to me and the people that I have on, I would probably have mostly passive investors, people that want to be a passive investor and they have questions for me. So I could host a podcast and I could say, hey, you've never done a passive investing. I bet you there's a lot of things holding you back. Can we do a reverse interview where all I do is I just help you? It becomes recorded and helps a lot of other people, but I help you for free. I answer all of your questions for free. And my listener also benefits. There's having somebody on that's never done a passive investment, but they want to. And then there's also having people that have passively invested in your deal. So you could even ask them questions like, what were you scared about and how did you overcome it? Because now the listener follows their way. They're like, I was scared about that too. I'm going to overcome it. And now the next obvious thing is I'm going to invest with this person as well, because that's what the guest did. So you can have your own passive investors on as guests, or you can have other successful passive investors your show. Also, like Mauricio, you could have him on your show because he helps passive investors in a lot of ways. He creates the documentation. Sometimes the documentation is written on your behalf and not on your passive investor's behalf. And it would be nice to be able to ask questions like that. You probably wouldn't have a lender. It'd probably be ridiculous for you to have a lender. You probably wouldn't have another syndicator teaching you how to find a deal or how to raise money, because your passive investor doesn't want to raise money. They already want to passively invest. So that would be the criteria. It would be, how do I add value to my passive investor? How am I asking the right questions? How am I getting the right person on my show that adds value to that person? You can sneakfully, if that's a real word, sneakily. I like
it though. Let's make it a word.
You can also invite people that would be a good person for you to work with. So for example, I've had passive investors on my podcast, even that multi-billionaire that came off. I've had those guys on my podcast and I've asked questions like, what do you look for in a market? Why do you look? And remember, two ears, one mouth. Toward the end or on a different call, I can say, hey, I remember you came on the podcast and you said something about wanting to be in Atlanta. Well, I have some business partners that found a deal in Atlanta. A, I'd love to show it to you just to get your thoughts. And B, if you are open, if you have some capital ready to place, would love to work with you on it if it's something that meets your criteria. Now you're inviting that person as a guest and you're just building a stronger relationship with them. So you're just more likely to do deals with them in the future. So those are the criteria that I really would go off.
So if you enjoyed this clip and you want to see the entire episode, click here. And if you want to see other videos similar to this, click here.